back to Epcot. Yeah, I think here. Oh, unless you want to go down there. But I think this would be fast.
Welcome, folks.
Great day, guys.
Thank you, you too. Hi, Judy.
So we're gonna go do Spaceship Earth?
Huh?
We're gonna go do Spaceship Earth?
Sure.
Looks terribly precise, so you tell me which is which.
This is mine. Also, I remember I had trouble with my pepper right here. What do you mean not terribly precise? Mine is obviously more precise. Which direction are we going? We still have to do some over here. Do you want to go this way so then we can hit France?
Well, which way?
To the right.
Yeah, I don't care.
Because we have to do Earth Eats is the first one on this side.
Alright.
Oh yeah, it goes all the way back there. Oh yeah. I don't know where I'm going anymore in here.
No.
Yeah, it says World Showcase, so I think we're good. It's hot. Every once in a while there's like a breeze.
I wonder how they drew their permits.
Yeah, this is feeling more like that October.
Well, and if it's supposed to rain today, that makes sense.
Cause yeah.
It's all going
to rain. Remy and the refreshment. Ooh, that's a nice green. That's nice.
So it must be this one, right?
Oh, yeah, I didn't even think about that. Yeah, that's the only thing it can be. Disney bunnies probably have a different vibe.
Want to take pictures?
I'm in a bunny. Yeah, I'm distracted by the bunny that literally doesn't care that there are people around it. Yeah, I might need you to hold my water bottle. That did not work. Raised beef poutine. Hi. Are you living your best life? You are the least timid rabbit I've ever seen in my life. Oh, friendship, folks.
I would say do the appearance first.
Yeah, I already got that.
And then we'll... No, but I'm saying talk about the appearance.
Oh. I mean, it looks like poutine, but with beef. What are your thoughts?
So it's braised beef poutine. It looks a little heavy for today because it's awfully hot out.
There's a nice braise though.
There is kind of a slight glistening of grease to the gravy, which I'm sure will make it delicious.
Is there, they said relish, but like...
Well, I'm guessing the relish is kind of down towards the bottom or underneath or something. I mean, it looks very good, so we'll see.
Okay. Okay, confirmed. I'm still not a beef person. I don't hate it. Oh, got a nice squeak on the cheese. Like, I don't mind the beef, but it's definitely just a me not liking beef. Give me your thoughts.
So it was the braised beef poutine with French fries, horse and garlic, thyme, herbs, cheese sauce, cheese curds, and gherkin relish.
Yeah.
Overall, I think it's very good. We split it between the two of us, which I think worked out perfect because it is kind of heavy for such a hot day. So that worked out good. I thought the beef was excellent. If you like a pot roast kind of beef, it just shreds good. It's very, very tender, very moist. The gravy was excellent. If you like a good beef gravy, I mean, it was very, very good. And the cheese curds, two thumbs up on the cheese curds because they were a real hunk of cheese curds.
Unlike some people.
And I really hate when I get poutine and it's got shredded cheese on it because it's not poutine.
Canada.
But overall, it was good. The only thing that disappoints me is there was no gherkin. It was supposed to be gherkin relish on it, and there was no gherkin relish on it, which I have no idea how that would have tasted. In my mind, it would have been a nice, sweet, light addition to it.
It would have been a different flavor.
Yeah, but unfortunately, I didn't get to test it. But overall, very, very good.
I liked it. I didn't really like the beef, but I didn't expect to. And I was happy there was no relish. Wait, did you want to look at anything else before we... I wasn't done looking. We're going to look at the book.
No.
Okay, we got the Tropical Sea Breeze from Joffrey's in Canada. I've never been to Joffrey's. And I think they have a agave straw. We each got one. It definitely has a coconut flavor, but... just a nice change. I don't know how people walk around drinking without lids on their cups. Are they not as clumsy as I am?
Very good.
I like it. And this is what I wanted yesterday when I was like, I just keep drinking water. But this will still hydrate you. It's not like...
And the tartness of the lemonade is what makes it refreshing.
Yeah. Ireland, I wish you were open. I was about to be like, where's my phone? It's in my hand. And now we're walking through. Actually, here, let me switch. Well, that was a nice break. Sit in the shade.
It's very good. Very much enjoyable.
Yeah, good choice, good choice. Because, yeah, I think they have, like, a different specialty drink in each shop. Oh, yeah, there's nothing in the UK.
I really wanted to have this truck. I won't enjoy it.
Yeah.
Nobody's here.
Yeah. Because it's noon. We just saw on Instagram that Molly is flying. I'm assuming she's going to Disneyland today, which is fine, but that means we won't see her. But maybe other people will be. Here. My dad's like obsessed with Quincy, so that's cool. But France is like empty, so I'm gonna take pictures. So we're gonna do the three cheese beignet. All those Remy ears are cute. And the escargot, which is a risky pick for me. I think he's done escargot on the cruise. I don't think I've ever noticed this before. Is this like a thing? in France/Paris. Here in the Ratatouille spot. I think there is seats back here. So. We'll see. Oh, hi, Remy. How are you, sir? Are you excited for your ride to open in October? Wait times and they are insane. It's supposed to be a 5 today on touring plans, and I think Test Track is like 2 hours. It's insane. I really want to ride Test Track, and obviously when we're here right now there's a chance of rain, but in Spaceship Earth is like 30. Touring plans has to wait to ride, so that's why. Oh, there's a nice little breeze. That's what I was hoping. Breeze off the water. And we did come here last night, obviously, so the line for France, I should maintain one train of thought. So we were talking on our way walking over to France that we think that maybe, because it's not that busy right now, 12:30, that it's probably, we're like, oh, it's weekday, so it's fine. But I think the issue is that people come after work, it's fine, like issue, not like that they're not allowed to, obviously they are. Welcome. Come, buy food, buy drinks, enjoy yourself. But that does make it busier. So we're thinking about going over to Magic Kingdom, and we may not actually, especially because our next Epcot day is a weekend. So we'll probably try to do a ride or two. We'll do Figment. We might go into the Seas. We're trying to take it like easy and not like push ourselves. This trip was not planned, so just like it's just an extra fun thing. So go over to Magic Kingdom, maybe enjoy Magic Kingdom, or just go to like the resorts and just like relax, take things in. Depending on the time, maybe we can get like a DVC tour or something. Plus then we can ride the monorail. The Epcot monorail is open now. So, but the line for France, I mean, it was long, but it's not as long as it was last night. And I was like, oh, maybe we should wait. But my dad was like, no, let's just do it. Because it's probably not going to get any better, especially since Saturday we're coming back. And I don't think we'll come back to this side of the park. We're going to try to finish our Remy thing. And just go around and then finish it. So, that makes sense. We might ride a friendship boat. We haven't done that in forever. I don't know. We do have to find Remy in Japan, which we skipped yesterday because we were having trouble. And I remember Japan being a hard one last year. It is hot. Sometimes you get a nice breeze. And we're from New York, so it gets hot there, but it's hotter here, and it's pretty humid. Sweat is just pouring off of me, which is gross, but I just want to be realistic. And I feel like I'm not a big sweater, but it's my legs, which I feel like my legs definitely never sweat. But what are you gonna do, you know? And I was gonna wear a Figment t-shirt, obviously I'm not, because, which works out, because I forgot my Figment ears, so I just wore my Ariel ones. I really like my Figment ones, they're clearly magic, and I completely forgot them. I feel so bad. I wanted to take pictures of them here and post them on Instagram, but that's fine. I love clearly magic ears. And then, but it was just too hot in a t-shirt yesterday, even with the sleeves rolled up. It's just too heavy. So fortunately I brought extra tank tops, so. He had moved pretty far through the line when I like went back to him and then told me to come sit down. So hopefully it's not too much longer. Yesterday he was wearing orange, so it was easy to find him. I brought smaller sunglasses today because I'm just wearing a fanny pack, but these don't fit as well over my regular glasses. But I hear something clicking. Are they like doing stuff behind this wall? Maybe. I'm sure they are. It is pretty back here. This music is getting quite heavy. Like maybe from Ratatouille, I don't know. I haven't seen that movie in forever. So this, I assume, is the croissant or the escargot.
Yep.
And then this is the baguette.
Croissant.
Or beignet.
This is the beignet.
Oh, that.
That's
this,
the croissant.
This is the escargot.
So this is the beignet with cheese. That's the escargot croissant.
I feel like it is grosser being able to see it. Fine, I'm gonna be brave. Sometimes you get a nice breeze off the water. Is there like gooey cheese in there? Oh, look at that. Oh, delicious. Okay. I feel like I wanna eat this first.
Yeah. Which one?
Oh, it's warm. Okay, I see the snail and I'm tempted to avoid it, but I'm not.
This is literally, because this is an actual snail. What I've had before is more like minced up.
That's what I thought this was gonna be. Okay, okay. I'm gonna do it. Completely honest, objectively, it tastes fine. It tastes like a baguette. Can I have my water if that's what you're getting? Whatever, that's what I mean. It's hot, I can't think. But the whole time I was chewing it, I wanted to gag. There was nothing making me gag other than my brain being like, you're chewing a snail. It didn't taste chewy, it didn't taste funny. I think I would have preferred it if it was minced, which is definitely what I thought it was.
Like, I've had escargot before, where you really just, there's a little bit of texture there, but it's mostly just garlic sauce and flavor. You really just, it's an excuse to eat garlic. I thought it was good. It's fine. The sauce, the seasoning is what gives the flavor that's on the baguette, on the croissant.
Yeah, sorry, I'm making you say it now.
Now you got me saying it. But I mean, it's chewy. The only thing that the escargot brings to it is chewy. Doesn't really bring any flavor whatsoever. It's just, it gives it a little more chewiness than you would get with a a nice flaky croissant, but the croissant was cooked good. I think it's seasoned very well. Overall, I enjoyed it. If you want to say that you've eaten snails once, this is probably a good way to do it.
I can now say I have done that.
You know, put that off your bucket list. Is it anything to die for? No. Honestly, you could make the same thing and leave the snail out of it, and it would be perfectly fine. I think it would taste the same. There'd just be a little bit of texture difference to it. But it was good.
I'm gonna get your immediate reaction. That's a lot of cheese.
It is. And it's very thin. It's very liquidy, so it moves around.
Is it really hot?
I mean, not hot, spicy hot.
No, like
but
hot
temperature. Wise, it's good and warm.
Okay.
I mean, it does very much have a white gravy flavor to it.
Okay,
like
that's
if
what,
you've ever had sausage gravy and biscuit.
Wait, that's what Disney Food Blog said.
It's not as tasty as sausage gravy.
Because it's not gravy, it's just cheese.
It is a gravy. I mean, if somebody were to just give me a spoonful of this,
you would say it was gravy, not cheese.
I would think it was gravy, not cheese, yeah. I mean, it's good.
It's good, fine. Okay.
It's flavorful.
At least this beignet is not going to kill you.
Right?
Everyone talks about the Mickey beignets. But, like, nobody warns you that you need to be careful when eating them. Because they're, like, going to kill you. Because you're going to inhale the powdered sugar. Okay, let me eat it. Film me eating it, I guess, because there's no way I can eat this. And it is recording.
It's recording now? Okay.
Yeah. It looks like sausage gravy, that's for sure. Like, it has that, like, peppery look to it.
Mm-hmm.
Chewier than I expected the beignet part.
Yeah.
It's more like a normal donut.
Yeah.
I feel like... So I don't dislike it, like, at all. But, like, is there a lot of flavor? Like, I feel like there's not a lot of flavor. Mostly, if I bite into the donut part, I'm trying to get a lot of cheese and stuff, I get mostly donut.
Yes. But
You have three cheeses. I should get some cheese flavor here.
It's not the standout. I thought the cheese would really stand out, and it doesn't. Is this good? Yes. Will I probably take a fork and eat what's left on the plate? Yes. Would I? The lines can get very long at that booth. Would I get in line and wait, you know, for an hour to get this? No, I would not.
Right, I feel like it would be less popular, but I think they should have put a stronger cheese in here. Like a goat cheese or something, just to add like a level of flavor. Like, I taste pepper.
Yeah.
Like black pepper. Like
I think even if you had something of a cheese in there that had a little more form to it,
mm-hmm.
So when you bit into it, you bit into some cheese, I think that would make a big difference too.
It was good. I definitely don't think I could have eaten a whole one on my own. That's the heaviest thing we've eaten all day.
It is very heavy.
Donut's almost a little sweet, which I feel like that is what a beignet is. But maybe less sweet would have been better. I don't know. Those are my thoughts. feel like last time, like, we went hunting all back, like, in the back, and then it ended up being, like, in the front. But I feel like we've looked everywhere in the front. He's looking back there. I've never eaten a tapenade. Because it has to be like somewhere you can't touch it, but you can see it. Or it could just be like stickers. Yeah, if you didn't see yours. I don't know where my dad is, but I found him. He's up here by the bathroom. Hi! And he has a machine. You're in Italy, and you know what happens in Italy?
This is the same tomato.
Hey, tomato. Yeah, it's gotta be tomato. That's like the fastest we've ever found them in Italy. Italy's like always a hard one.
Yeah.
Germany is pretty.
Oh,
my God. That sounds good too though, doesn't it? The left stuff, the potato flatbread with butter, cinnamon, and sugar. I mean, I feel like you can't go wrong with that. This occasionally has shade. There were no, are there tables over there?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll follow you, hold on. The left stuff. But it's just like butter and sugar, cinnamon, what was it? Should I rip it in half? Should I rip it in half?
Sure.
Thank you. I mean, I feel like it's kind of like a old school. I've heard this is like a poor thing. I didn't think I was poor growing up.
I could see that.
But where you put butter, no, but like in real, like in our, in America, like putting cinnamon and sugar, or butter, cinnamon and sugar on bread. Apparently that's a poor thing. I call that a smart person.
Yeah. Oh, very good, very, very tasty.
I was worried the bread might be dry.
Yeah, no, it's not.
Here, let me try just the bread. You still got butter down there. Good job. That is good. I like that.
This is very good.
We approve. And it's a potato flatbread, so that's like basically healthy, right? The potato is a healthy food.
I mean, it's good. It's sweet, but not too sweet.
So I feel like this is my complaint with a lot of stuff at places like this. And maybe this is how it's supposed to be, but like the pretzel part is very dry.
Yeah.
So everything else is fine. It tastes good. Although 100% lefse over the kringle.
Oh. Honestly,
cheaper, better.
All the stuff that's in the kringle, if you put that on the lobster and rolled it up.
Oh, would try, would eat. 100%.
Would be amazing. I realize there's a volume difference, but the lobster is like half the price.
And like, I don't think this is dry because it's poorly made. I think it's meant to be dry.
Yeah, I think so.
R.I.P. ears. We're in line for a cab here. They sent us on the right side. Here. Like to say that in the extended queue for this, they definitely kept that claustrophobic feeling that is in the room. Part of the vibe, I guess. And the plexiglass is still up. I'm not even claustrophobic, and it makes me uncomfortable. But we're almost there. We're gonna see Donald the Goose.
Where's the little bee?
It must be operated by a